When the going gets tough in Washington, the tough go to K Street, home of the city's lobbyists and crisis solvers. That's what Pakistan's doing as lawmakers criticize the country's leaders over what they knew and when they knew it about Osama bin Laden's whereabouts. Lizzie O'Leary has more from Washington. Lizzie?
Hey, Mark. Well, I just got off the phone with Pakistan's top lobbyist, and he told me he's been meeting basically nonstop since the president's announcement to try to push back on the criticism against Pakistan. He says his contract isn't going anywhere right now. He's worked for them for 27 years. He would stand by the country. Indeed, the embassy of Pakistan spent $3 million lobbying over the past 3 years here in D.C. Their two-year spending is roughly on pace with what Egypt spent over a two-year period. These countries both have big presences here. Members of Congress have been railing against Pakistan, questioning what members of the government may have known about where Osama bin Laden was hiding, even threatening the country's $18 billion in aid. Now, that's the moment having a well-connected lobbyist comes in handy.
Members of Congress are going to be playing to their constituents with this. And the job of the Pakistan's lobbyists here and foreign agents is going to be saying to members of Congress that your constituents' interest and the U.S. interest lies in continuing aid to Pakistan.
Indeed, Pakistan's lobbyists have a long history of meeting with members of Congress, 205 contacts with members, their staffs, even a few reporters in D.C. over the past 2 years, indeed in 2008. The lobbyists set up a meeting to introduce the Prime Minister, Raza Gilani, to then-Senator Barack Obama. Now, the ambassador to Pakistan told us the real task of their lobbyists right now is winning the hearts and minds of the ordinary American citizens who, after all, vote for the members of Congress that Pakistan is working to influence right now, Mark.
Lizzie O'Leary. Lizzie, thanks.